So my question is, trans women athletes are now being allowed to compete in women's sports events in many international competitions. Do you think that this is a step in the right direction? Why or why not?
Yes, last year we witnessed Miss Universe being transgender. Recently, Brave Miss Universe Philippines contestant vows crowd after answering questions about trans men in female sport. When I saw this response, I was amazed. I don't know if you have seen this. I will read this article from the Gateway Pundit before I play the video so you can see exactly. A Brave Miss Universe Philippine contestant wowed the crowd with her bold answers after being asked a tough questions about transgender athletes.
So my question is, trans women athletes are now being allowed to compete in women's sports events in many international competitions. Do you think that this is a step in the right direction? Why or why not?
I am all for equality with all genders, and I believe that we have the right to participate in any sports. However, I believe that there's a biological reason that we should not allow trans women in the women category, because I believe that there is a right time for that and there's right measurements to be done. Thank you.
Thank you.
It takes a brave lady to stand up to speak like this, especially in our times where when you stand up for the truth or what you believe in, you can easily be canceled or you will receive backlash. We saw what happened last year when Miss Universe was a transgender. And we are seeing this on a daily basis where they have been allowed to compete in women's sport. I don't understand why people are actually scared, you know, to speak up. Some knows the truth, but they can never speak up because of, I don't know. Now, in another clip, Megyn Kelly interviewed groups of sorority sisters who filed a lawsuit against the University of Wyoming after a transgender man was allowed to live in their house. I don't know if you've seen this. Take a look at this.
Complaint are shocking. Here's one of them. Alleging that he behaved inappropriately around the sorority sisters on numerous occasions, including once when Artemis, quote, had an erection visible through his leggings. Other times he had a pillow in his lap. There are similar stories going on about him watching the girls getting an erection, watching a girl change her top. She wasn't wearing a bra. He was staring at her. Later that day, he appeared during the incident. Somebody told the woman that they had seen that he had during the incident and stood near the door with his hands over. He sat in the back of the sorority yoga class for an hour in December, watching the assembled young women flex their bodies. I mean, I cannot imagine what it was like for you gals, Hannah, in there dealing with this obvious man, but also one who's clearly getting aroused by just being around you. Can you give us some idea of what that felt like for you?
It's a weird, gut-wrenching feeling that every time I leave my room, there's a possibility that I'll walk past him in the hall, whatever setting that may be in. And it's never a pleasant encounter. And that's the scary part. It's a weird feeling just to know that I could run into him anytime, full access to the house. But this just goes to show, like, we need women's spaces for that reason. Like, our house is our home, just like any else's home. Like, you go home at the end of the day to feel comfortable and relax in your own skin. And you can't do that knowing that this individual has full access to your house.
It is also really uncomfortable.
Just because some of the girls in the house, I know, so some girls live in constant fear in their home, and our home is supposed to be a safe space. And to paint you a picture just a little bit further, men are never allowed on the second floor of our house except for move in and move out just to help us lift heavy things upstairs. So it is seriously an only female space. It is so different than living in the dorms, for instance, where men and women can co-mingle on the floors. That is not the case in a sorority house. We share just a couple main bathrooms on the upstairs floor, but it is just us who lives there, and it's supposed to be a safe place that we can go to rest our heads at night.
Yes, this is actually sad to be seeing this happening. I've seen some trans actually coming out to really talk about this, and some really don't agree that this should be happening, but you will see some still standing up to say this is right. They are not safe. There are so many places that we see this on daily basis, washroom, this, that. But when you want to talk about this, it's a big problem. Why should this be happening? In every domain, these people are dominating. It's not like I hate any person. I don't hate any person. When you learn to maintain your lane, you know, learn to stay on your own space, you know, don't do what will make somebody feel uncomfortable. I don't have any problem with you. I start having, you know, some kind of thought toward you when I realize you are extending to places you are not supposed to be. We should accept this reality. Like I recently saw where some people says if you are born and you start following on some of this procedure at a very tender age, when you grow up knowing that you want to, I don't know, you want to be a woman, at that time they can even have some kind of consideration. Somebody will grow up maybe just 40, 50, the next day I want to be a woman with white hairs, and the society starts saying, you know, you're different. You want to use the same space as biological women. That is where we see a lot of things happening. This should not be happening. If they can put up some laws into places like this, where there should be that kind of limitations, I think it will be okay. It will be extremely difficult for the society to actually accept certain things like this. I understand we need to coexist, but for security reasons, even in dormitory schools, I used to see, you know, some kind of spaces, but nowadays, this is not happening.
You know, when you have the chief reporter on the beat of COVID for the New York Times talking about how questioning or pursuing the question of the lab leak is racist, the world has gone mad. When you're not able to say out loud and in public that there are differences between men and women, the world has gone mad.
You say we're not allowed to talk about these things, but they're all over the internet. I can Google them. I can find them everywhere. I've heard about every story you mentioned.
Of course.
So I'm just suggesting, of course, people are allowed to cover whatever they want to cover.
But you and I both know, and it would be delusional to claim otherwise, that touching your finger to an increasing number of subjects that have been deemed third rail by the mainstream institutions and increasingly by some of the tech companies will lead to reputational damage, perhaps.